Time to talk Tulane football. Joined alongside the voice of the Green Wave, Todd Graffagnini. Let's just get right to it. Tulane's coming off a disappointing 2-10 season. How good can they be this year? How good is quarterback Joe Kemp going to be?
Well, Fletch, it's going to be hard to say. Joe Kemp doesn't have the experience that, say, some quarterbacks have had in the past. Really, he's still a true freshman as far as playing experience. He had to redshirt last year at the end of the season because of injuries. I think his maturation is a really big key for Tulane this year. If he gets better, I believe he's going to have a running game to back him up, and that's going to take a lot of pressure off.
Speaking of the running game, Andre Anderson, he's on the Doak Walker watch list. You've got some good young freshmen like Peyton Jason from Jesuit High School. Can that unit really carry this team offensively?
Absolutely. They have Andre Anderson is very well could be playing on Sundays next year. Peyton Jason has been the surprise of camp. He came in as the fourth running back, and now he's a solid number two. He's going to get a lot of action. This is a very deep and talented running back stable, and they've got a solid offensive line too. And I really believe, again, they're going to be able to run the ball effectively all year long, and that's going to take a lot of pressure off Kemp.
Before we talk about the defense, let's talk about Coach Bob Toledo, and again, maybe overall for this team. Coach Bob Toledo's done a great job recruiting, really reaching out to the coaches in Louisiana, something he said he wanted to do. Can they take a step forward and move past that bad 2-10 season last year?
Absolutely, and it really starts with Coach Toledo. You know, him getting out in the state, seeing these coaches, these high school, these camps, these kids, they're getting early recruits from these camps. They're reaping the benefits of these things, and it's been a lot of fun to watch, and you're going to see kids playing on Friday night that are a direct result of these camps. You know, DJ Banks from West Monroe, you know, he's going to be playing a lot this year, and that's one of the reasons why.
Of course, Tulane opens up against Tulsa in the Superdome, national TV Friday night. Two more quick questions. The defense struggled mightily last season. Will they be improved with a new coordinator?
They have to be improved. The thing about Conference USA, Fletch, as you know, it's a spread offense league. 90% of the snaps last year that Tulane took defensively were against 3 and 4 wideout sets. So you got to stop the spread. It's unbelievable how it happens. Quarterbacks in the shotgun, you're not going to see many under center. Linebackers is a thin position right now. The DBs, I think, are going to be a strength. You have to have strong DBs in this league, but of course you got to rush the passer. If you allow these passers to sit back there and pick you apart, it could be tough.
Final question, moment of truth. Ty Graffagnini, a prediction for the Tulane Green Wave. What do they finish this year, 12-game regular season?
It's tough. They're going to be better. They will be better, that I can guarantee. It's tough to go wins and losses right now because, again, you don't know what the maturation of Joe Kemp's going to be. You don't know how the defense is going to respond. But it's going to help big time to have Andre Anderson and Jeremy Williams back. But they're going to be vastly improved over a year ago.
And we shall see Friday night when they open up against the University of Tulsa.